Hi everyone, Grant K here for the Flame Premium Learning Channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at the improved context views in Flame Premium 2016 Extension 1. In previous versions of Flame Premium, Flame artists had a maximum of 2 context slots. These have always been very useful for a variety of work. However, Flame artists have reported that 2 context slots are simply not enough. So in this version of Flame Premium, the number of context views has been increased to 10. This should help the majority of you, but some changes had to be made to take on 10 context slots. Now, since this feature does not rely on any type of footage, you can use your own material to follow along. So go ahead and create or load a flow graph with a few nodes. Now, when it came to assigning the 2 context slots in the previous version of Flame Premium, the context views could be assigned and you could cycle between them. But with 10 context slots, this becomes a little more challenging. So the workflow has been altered accordingly. We'll cover all the different methods, so please watch the entire video and pick the workflows that work best for you. Let's start off by looking at the different ways you can now set a context. There are 3 methods you can choose from: Contextual Menus, Interface Button, and Keyboard Hotkeys. To set a context using the Contextual Menu, select the node and call up the Contextual Menu. When you select the Set as Context menu, you will now see 10 free slots. So you can pick whichever slot you want for this node. If you wanted to clear the context off the selected node, just choose the Clear Selected Context. There is also another option to clear all context slots instead of going through each one. What's really cool about this context list is that as you assign each slot, the node name will be displayed next to the context number. So you can manually assign particular nodes to various context slots. However, if you're not too concerned about the particular slot numbers, then you can just choose Set as Next Available Context. This chooses the next free context slot to assign to the node. Now, here is the big difference if you've used previous versions of Flame Premium. In previous versions, when the 2 context slots were full, you could keep assigning new nodes and the old context slots would be overwritten as you cycle through them. You probably won't have to do this since you have 10 context slots. But the change is that context slots can only be overwritten when explicitly chosen. In other words, when you fill up all 10 context slots, the Set as Next Available Context stops working because all the slots are full. You can either pick a particular context slot to replace, or you could clear the slots and Set as Next Available Context will use the empty slots again. So to reiterate, setting context views does not cycle any more compared to previous versions. And hopefully you won't need to. The next method of setting a context is the context button to the right of the interface. The default behavior of this button is Set as Next Available Context. So whatever node is selected will be assigned the next available context slot. The context button can also remove the context of a node assigned with an existing context slot. And there is also a drop-down menu that will give you the same contextual options, including Clear Selected and Clear All Context Slots. This matches what you would find in the context menu. The third and final method for setting a context is the keyboard hotkeys. In previous versions of Flame Premium, the hotkey for setting a context was equals. If you used the Smoke Classic profile, it would have been minus. In this version of Flame Premium, if you hold equals and click on a node, you now get the context view pop-up window. This shows all the assigned and available context slots. The next available slot is automatically highlighted in yellow. So if you just hit enter, the node will be assigned to that slot. To remove a context view off a node, hold equals, and click on a node. Now you can bypass the pop-up window. Just press Meta equals and click on a node. This will assign it to the next available context slot. But please remember what I said earlier. Once you run out of available slots, this operation will stop working. As a quick tip, holding either equals or meta equals will remove the context slot off a clicked node. Now let's go back to the pop-up window. Hold equals and click on the node again. Instead of pressing enter, you could just click on a slot. Alternatively, if you know you want to assign this node to slot 9, just press 9 on your keyboard. So those are your three methods with the pop-up window. Enter, click, or number selection with the keyboard. Now we've been assigning context slots, but we haven't really been looking at them. In order to accommodate the number of context views, the hotkeys have also changed. Instead of just 1 or 2, you now hold space, followed by the context number. So pressing 1 through 9 will give you those context views. Please note that context slot 10 is mapped to the 0 hotkey. You can also click the Viewer pull-down menu and choose the various context viewers. It's also worth mentioning that the context viewers are available through the Batch tab in the player. Coming back to the batch schematic, it's very likely that you'll set context slots across a range of nodes in the flow graph. Now, if you wanted to find which nodes had a context, you could look for the context description under the node. Expanding on this further, you could press Alt equals, and this will frame all the nodes with an assigned context. So you can search all the nodes based on the context setting. You can also press Tab and Shift Tab hotkeys to navigate each of the highlighted nodes with the context. You should always be able to find the node you are looking for. Now, one final function regarding context views is that you can assign them to node outputs. At first, that sounds like exactly what you've been doing the whole time. This is true, but you do have nodes in batch that have different outputs. It could be a front or a mat, but you also have auxiliary outputs that you could get from action and certain other nodes. In any case, you can click on an output and assign a context. For example, to assign the mat output of this node as a context, hold meta equals and click it. This will assign it to the next available context slot. Or the other option is to hold equals and click, and this will bring up the context view pop-up window. These are currently the only two ways to assign specific outputs as contextual views. When you look under the node, it has a regular context description. However, if you look at the context list with either the pop-up window or contextual menus, the description will be more detailed next to each slot. Now, to add to this, you could select the front output of the node and assign it as a context as well. When you have multiple context slots assigned to the outputs of a single node, you will get multiple context indicators under the node. And if you need more detail as before, just check out the context list. The context view is not a flashy tool compared to other tools in Flame Premium, but it is equally important for working fast and keeping track of everything through the flow graph. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to the Flame Premium Learning Channel for future videos.